Thanks for joining. We have Cassandra Wonderly here. She's from ProMedica Defiance Regional Hospital, OBGYN, the women's unit, and she is a lactation consultant. Cassandra, why don't you go ahead and give us a little bit about you, your background, and what you do at ProMedica Defiance?
Okay. So I'm really excited to talk about breastfeeding support here. So I am the lactation consultant here at ProMedica Defiance Regional Hospital. So I see all of our inpatients, see some outpatients that might need some assistance once you're discharged from the hospital. And of course, take phone calls, and there's lots of different things that I do around here. I'm also the unit coordinator, so that's just another half of my job. But I'm really excited to talk about breastfeeding support. So there's so many topics about breastfeeding that I kind of could talk for hours about, but we're just gonna very lightly kind of scratch the surface here. All right, so just a little bit about me here. So I've been an OB nurse for 13 years. So I've worked my entire career here at ProMedica Defiance Regional Hospital. I've been an IVCLC for about the past 6 years. So this just means I went through a ton of education, some clinical experience, and took a board certified test. So I really do love my job, and I'm really passionate about helping parents meet their feeding goals. Support is vital. So breastfeeding truly does take a village. I really am passionate about providing support for people and giving them the right support, because I really had some difficulty myself with breastfeeding and I didn't seek out support. And I really feel like that negatively impacted how I ended up feeding my babies. So I really just want everybody everywhere to know that there's support out there, and that I just want to make it easier for people to find, because it's difficult. So I'm going to talk about our breastfeeding support and services that we do here at ProMedica Defiance Regional Hospital. So right before even delivery, we have prenatal education classes. So we have a comprehensive childbirth education and a spinning babies class. These classes are held monthly at our Women's Center with our lovely childbirth and spinning babies educator, Lisa Grubb, where it says the IBCLC for inpatient support. That's me. So I try to make it in and see all of our breastfeeding patients throughout their stay. So hopefully you'll see me a couple of times while you're here at our hospital. We do Ohio First Steps for healthy babies. So this is an initiative by the Ohio Department of Health and the Ohio Hospital Association. So it's just an initiative to help promote support and protect breastfeeding. So this program's a lot like the Baby Friendly Initiative. This is similar. It's put together by UNICEF and the World Health Organization, but this one is free for Ohio hospitals to participate in. So the program has 10 steps with specific requirements. So if you meet the requirements for 2 steps, you can earn a star. So 5 total stars are possible. Our hospital does have all 5 stars, and we were the first hospital in the ProMedica system to earn this recognition. So this has really helped our hospital to develop practices that are beneficial for not just our breastfeeding babies, but all of our babies. And I really feel like throughout the system, it's done the same thing. So staff education is something that's a requirement for the Ohio First Steps. So all of our nurses have extra breastfeeding education. So this is so beneficial to our patients to come in and get experienced, well-educated help and support. I also do outpatient follow-up visits to allow us to continue to help work on anything that may have been difficult for you while you were in the hospital, or just if you're home and then you start to have some difficulty. You can call me up and we can schedule something for you to come in. The best thing about these visits is they're free, and they happen right here in our hospital. I just have a little room right outside our unit, so you're still coming to the same place that you delivered at. We also have a support group. So once again, just adding in another layer of support. We like to call ourselves the ProMedica Super Moms. So this group is on Facebook. We have monthly meetings, either in person or via Zoom, and the details are all on the Facebook page. So there are over 300 members. So if you post a question, you are going to get a response from members who have been through everything that you've been through before, and they're going to answer your question and help support you. And this definitely is just adding into that more layers of support as much as we can for you. So another thing that we like to do that I feel like helps support breastfeeding and just helps support all of our babies is skin to skin. So this is after delivery, all infants are placed skin to skin as soon as possible, regardless of how you deliver. So we're getting babies skin to skin, even in the C-section room and the recovery room. So we take this pretty seriously around here. It's so ingrained that it's just a part of our normal routine. So you might hear it called the golden hour, but it really is like the first few hours where everything else can wait. We just really want to give baby a chance to get that first feed in and have a gentle welcome into the world. So it's been shown to increase early breastfeeding success and even increase the length of breastfeeding after hospital discharge. So I'm speaking a lot about this right after delivery, but skin to skin anytime is very beneficial. It's not just for the birth parent either. So we also encourage partners to hold their baby skin to skin. So you can see here this list of skin to skin benefits. So it really just helps regulate everything for baby right after delivery, because for baby, this is a pretty stressful experience coming out of a warm, dark, comfortable womb out into the reality of this bright, crazy world. So decreasing stress for mom too, because it's just really that baby right there. Mom gets to touch her baby right away and just have that nice bonding moment. So it also helps reduce maternal bleeding right after delivery too, because it's releasing some oxytocin. So that kind of helps get everything back to normal. And that also helps with breastfeeding. So benefits of breastfeeding, which there are many, and you're going to see here, I just have a few of them. So you can see for the breastfeeding parent, it reduces the risk of several types of cancer and heart disease, high blood pressure, autoimmune diseases. It's always available, and you get less time off work related to your baby being sick. For the baby, of course, bonding, again, for both. Always available, just like I said before. It's going to provide antibodies to help protect your baby against illness. It's easily digested, and you can see it reduces the risk of like SIDS and cancer and ear infections, common infections like that. And the list just goes on. It's really amazing. It changes and adjusts in response to baby saliva to meet baby's needs as they grow, which is just fascinating. It's constantly changing even between feeds. And when we're talking about antibodies, if you as a breastfeeding parent are exposed to, say, a virus or bacteria, your body starts to make those antibodies to fight those. And then those antibodies can be found in your milk within 20 minutes, which is quite amazing to me. So you're getting protection for your baby right away, right after you're exposed to something. So no other type of food can do that. Another thing to help with infection is a breastfed baby can get up to 10 trillion white blood cells in a day, which that just, I can't even fathom that. So much support against infection. Another thing too, with, you know, like formula recalls and things that we've had, breast milk can't be recalled. It literally is just specific for the breastfeeding parent and that baby. So of course this list here just scratches the surface of all the benefits that are out there. So let's talk about breast milk composition. I felt like this is important because some people don't really realize the difference in between the stages that breast milk goes through. So it goes through these stages just to help protect your baby and keep giving them nutrition throughout the entire time. I do want to just, it's hard to see this picture right here, but it just hits home that there's major differences in what is in breast milk versus what's in formula. So formula does provide nutrition, but breast milk has all these other protective factors, like the antibodies that we talked about before, that absolutely cannot be replicated. So I just want to take a few minutes here and talk about a few more amazing things that are found in breast milk. So Hamlet, not sure if you've ever heard of this before. It's been out in research for a while. So this is a complex formed from a protein and an acid, and these are found in human milk and found in the stomachs of breastfed babies. So this just fascinates me. research in Sweden found that Hamlet can actually kill up to 40 types of cancer cells. That's amazing. One study found that it killed bladder cells, bladder cancer cells in humans, and did not harm any healthy cells, which is also huge. One study found that it dramatically shrunk brain tumors in rats, which again, just fascinates me. So it'll be so amazing in the future to see what more comes of studying this. And maybe we'll even see it as a first-line cancer treatment in the future. I get excited about this. I'm a nerd about that, but very hopeful for that. Prebiotics are another thing. So these encourage a baby's gut to create its own probiotics. So probiotics are good bacteria that protect the gut, and they are specific to each baby and just amazing. Just another way that breastfeeding protects your baby. So now let's talk about the different stages here. So we have colostrum. So this is the first milk that you get right after delivery. And there's small amounts to match baby's small stomach size. So you can see here in this picture that I've included each day, see day one, that belly is so small, it's the size of a cherry. So in the days that we're getting colostrum, like this day one to three, you see we only get up to a walnut. So still pretty small belly. So this is packed with components to support baby's immune system. It supports gut health, and you might hear it called liquid gold. And that's just because a lot of times it will appear as this thick yellow liquid. It can be clear, it can be white, it can be lots of different colors, but that's kind of where we get that name. Next is transitional milk. So this happens about 3 to 5 days postpartum. So it's an increased milk production to support your rapidly growing baby. And it still contains all that immune support that colostrum contains. Colostrum is just more concentrated in it because your body kind of knows we want to protect this brand new baby. Engorgement can happen. And this is a little bit troublesome sometimes, but your breasts will start to feel full, warm, swollen, and all of a sudden you'll notice a lot more milk. So at this time, it's important to make sure feeding baby frequently to help with this. And this is where also some support can come in handy. Next is mature milk. So by about 4 to 6 weeks, you're going to have this. It's similar to transitional milk, but your supply kind of levels out a little bit because it knows that we've ramped up, we've gotten this baby to grow. Now we can just continue to help this baby grow. Still contains all the immune system support and continues to offer all of the benefits of breastfeeding for as long as you choose to breastfeed. So what exactly is breastfeeding? So recommendations for breastfeeding from the American Academy of Pediatrics and many other groups is exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months. Then you're going to introduce some complementary foods, but continued breastfeeding for up to 2 years and beyond. So this really is dependent on what you want to do for your feeding plan, for your feeding goal, because many, you know, the benefits are still there, even if you feed beyond that 2 years. So right here is just a list of just some of the ways that you can get breast milk to your baby. So directly latching and feeding at breast. Of course, you're going to get more bang for your buck here, but you're still reaping the benefits no matter how you feed breast milk. So you can pump and feed the breast milk in a bottle. You can combine latching and feeding in a bottle. You can use a tool to help due to some feeding trouble, and you just do what meets your goal. That's the main thing for me. So a parent, you know, speaking on this about using tools, and this is where support also is so important. So a parent might be told they can't breastfeed because their nipples are flat or some other reason. And often the person telling you this may not have the skills or know the most current information or research, when really, if breastfeeding is your goal, there are tools and techniques and information to be aware of. So that's why getting that appropriate support from, you know, the professionals that are going to know what is the most current things is so important. So this slide right here, breast is best, fed is best, social media. There are so many people with so many opinions about how a baby should be fed. So how do you make sense of all this? So just so much judgment out there. So the bottom line is your feeding goal is what matters. So your goal for me goal for me as a lactation consultant is to make sure you have all the accurate information to make an informed decision on how you choose to feed your baby. So, you know, social media will show you a lot. It's hard to wade through what's true or what's realistic from there. While there's nothing wrong with like a freezer full of milk, it's not realistic for everybody. So the person probably posting a picture of that either has worked really hard to get their milk supply to this, or they have an oversupply and they're going through complications that come along with that, that you don't see on social media. Mental health. So studies have shown that hormones involved in lactation can decrease the symptoms of anxiety and depression. This doesn't work the same for everyone. And mental health is something that really is not paid attention to as much as it should be. So it really is a complex issue, but it's just another place where good support can help. So I was just reading an article recently about a parent who had this image of exclusive breastfeeding in her mind because everybody in her life was telling her breastfeeding is the best thing for you to do and that it will be easy. But in reality, it wasn't easy. She felt shamed because she couldn't feed in the way she thought she was supposed to. She wasn't aware of the possibility of getting good lactation support and didn't seek it out. And her mental health suffered because of this, which it's so important. And making a feeding plan that supports that for you is doing what's best for you and really no one else's business. Regardless of all that information that's out there, you are feeding your baby in the way that you feel is the best for them and the best for your mental health at the same time. So I have some resource information here for you because once again, so important to get the good support out there. So I just want you to have a few resources here. This slide right here is going to talk about our childbirth education classes here at ProMedica Defiance. So we have our comprehensive childbirth education class, which includes some information about breastfeeding, and our spinning babies parent class. So you can see on here, both of these classes are free, which is so important for support. All of these layers of support I'm talking to you about are free. And your significant other person is welcome to attend. You can email Lisa Grubb right there if you're interested in doing any of these classes. So it's lisa.grubb@promedica.org. And I know she is so knowledgeable and so passionate about everything that she does. Definitely beneficial classes for you to go through. Next, of course, is our support group. So you can see our little flyer right here. So you'll find us on Facebook. So ProMedica Defiance Regional Hospital Breastfeeding Support Supermoms. Meetings might be by Zoom, so you want to join us on Facebook for details every month. And all you have to do is request to join, and we'll get you on there as soon as possible. So you can start posting some questions if you have them and get our 300 plus members to give you their input on it. Right here is my contact information. So I like this. Keep calm and please feel free to contact me. So definitely, if you're interested in some lactation support, talking on the phone about some things, coming in to be seen, anything like that, we can definitely arrange that. And you'll see I'm here Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 3:30. There's my office number right there, which is 783-4408. I'm the only one in the office, so small things there, but you can definitely leave me a message. I'll get back to you. And there's my email right there, cassandra.wonderly@promedica.org. So here's some other resources that I just want people to be aware of, because there are more than just us here at our hospital, although we give you lots of good support options. So you can see there the breastfeeding hotline. So this is completely free and someone's on call to answer questions at all times. So 24/7, 365, if you've got a question, they can answer it for you when it comes to lactation. You can also text the breastfeeding hotline to 839-863. A lot of people don't like to call anymore. They like to text. So I think that this is a very nice offering that they have right here. So WIC, also all the local county health departments in Ohio have breastfeeding peer helpers. So if you're eligible for WIC, that's just another layer of support that you have there to talk with someone and get some support. Infant risk for medication questions. So they also have an app here because a lot of times it's so medication is something that there are very few medications that you take that you can't breastfeed with. And a lot of times you'll get a lot of conflicting information. And the most common thing that you'll hear is, oh, you have to pump and dump for XYZ, when that might actually not be the most current research there. So infant risk does have all that current information. And I use the medical side of their app almost on a daily basis, I feel like. Very good resource right there for you. So check out their website for further information, because they also have some posts on there and you can read quite a bit of things. We also, like for our system, we have Toledo Hospital has a warm line. So you can leave a message there and they contact you back and you do get to talk with an IBCLC. So that is also another very good service right there. And here's just some of my resources that I used for my presentation today. And I just thank you very much for letting me talk with you about this. And it's just something that I feel is so, so important, is to get that good support, because breastfeeding really does, like I said before, it really takes a village. It really takes everybody in your corner as much as you can have.
Thanks, Cassandra. Yeah. Dr. Gibbs, did you have anything to add?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, good. First of all, Cassandra, I wish you'd just get a little bit more excited about this subject, because it showed. But I think the greatest thing as a physician looking at this that I have found, being an obstetrician for 35 years, breastfeeding is the only thing that, when you look into the scientific literature, breast milk is the only thing we can find that is just not, there's no research that it will ever come out, that has ever come out, that said, oh my God, don't breastfeed your child. And, when you think about that, and then everything else we have in medicine, there's always something on, or somebody, or some condition where we say, oh my gosh, please don't do this or take this medicine. But breastfeeding, you just can't find any reason for not taking it. And, we think of, in biology, if you take biology, we call biology, we call humans mammals. So we're actually classified in biology after mammals is referring to the breast tissue. So we're actually classified in biology according to the fact that our mothers can breastfeed our children. So, if you just look around, just to see the importance of what you're talking about. And I think that there's so many ways. There's a lot of barriers that I find that people, I just can't do that. I'm working, I'm this, I'm that. But I think talking to somebody like you that, where you could work around barriers and say, well, let's just do this and get a little bit to the baby. And, just even a little bit is better than none. And, again, in the research area in medicine, in breastfeeding, there are fabulous advantages to a baby who is breastfed. So I'm very excited about what you're talking about and can't wait to get this talk out to the community. Thank you. Thank you, Cassandra.
Well, thank you. Thanks.
Thank you guys both for joining us. Cassandra, thank you so much for this information. It'll be great to share with everybody.